Swiss Army shot. This one is actually King Oliver's Creole Jazz Band. See, King Oliver used to play in downtown New Orleans. Now, when Louis Armstrong was 6 years old, he was living with his mama and his sister, who were very sick. And so at the age of six, Louis Armstrong had to support the family. Now, going out the street with three of his friends, they started a little choral group. They started singing old jazz songs in a barbershop sort of style in the street. And people like King Oliver and Kid Ory, they'd see these kids playing on the street on their way to play in the clubs. And so they'd stop and they'd talk to them and show them a few things. And as time went on, Louis Armstrong found himself a little toy tin trumpet, and he had a job working on a rag wagon, going through the streets, and he'd play the trumpet at the age of seven, this little toy tin trumpet, by just buzzing it like a kazoo. And some big kids stole the trumpet, and as he chased them through the streets, they dropped it, and the truck ran over it, and that was the end of the trumpet. But the family that ran the rag recycling business, they chipped in, and they lent him the money to buy a real cornet that he bought in a shop for $5. And now when he was on the street playing this cornet, having been buzzing for a couple of years, at the age of seven or eight, well, Joe Oliver was able to show him a few things on the trumpet. So he had like the finest tutelage in the world with these players like Bunk Johnson and Joe Oliver. And by the time he was 16, 17, he was playing in the band with Joe. And a lot of people thought that he should move on to greater things. But Louis Armstrong always thought that Papa Joe was just absolutely the greatest and he would never leave him. And this is a piece that Papa Joe wrote for Louis Armstrong to kind of show off his young padawan when they played. It's called The Dipper Mouth Blues.